Hey guys, this is Connor from TeamEccenTrick here, bringing you a hero deck profile for you guys. Haven't posted up any deck profiles in a while due to some circumstances, which I'm not in particular going to get into. So after the ban list and the hit, I'm happy that my boy Stratos and Mally, or should I say Delicious, is back at 3. While my Orcas deck got hit because of my Nightmare Mermaid being banned, so I was gonna put up a Cyber Dragon Orcas deck profile for you guys, but Konami likes to fuck me over. So let's get right to the deck profile, shall we? So you all know, Triple Stratos, the king of all elemental heroes right now. He searches out any hero monster and destroys spells and traps. Now that's what I call a hero. 2 Shadow Mist, you don't need any more than 2. It helps out search out your heroes from your deck if you're sending it to the graveyard, special summoning it as you mass change. That's pretty much it. 1 Solid Soldier, I was playtesting with 2, but it seemed like it was too bricky at times, so I just cut it down to 1. And finally, the best card in my deck to make the OTK plays is the Elemental Hero Honest Neos. I can't believe they made this into a card. I mean, hey, I would prefer the regular Honest, but hey, Honest Neos, why not? Next up for the Vision Heroes, Triple Vision Hero Ferris. Basically, you discard another hero monster from your hand, special summon, and then place a vision hero from your deck to the spell and trap card zone. And you guys should know the rest, hopefully. 2 Increase. I really like this guy. It's just sometimes in the videos what we do, I sometimes forget about his secondary effect to place it in the spell and trap card zone if I take any effect damage or battle damage. So if you guys watch our duel videos on my heroes, you'll see that sometimes. It's only because I've been really overworked and such, and I've been really tired. And lastly, 2 Vision Hero Vion. I was trying it out at 3, but that was a huge mistake. So I prefer that too. Next for the Destiny Heroes, Triple Mally. I'm glad this is back at 3. I'm able to do my hero plays like more consistently now that it's back at 3. At 2, it was okay, but not showing any plays as much. Lastly, 1 Dynatag for the increase of Dystopia. I had to give it a 1,000 attack point boost and able to use his effect. Sometimes I use his hand, the hand effect to try to damage my opponent as well, instead of only just me. Next, Celestial. And lastly, Destiny Hero Plasma. I have been considering of just siding him because in like matchups against like back row decks, it doesn't really help. It only just negates like face-up monster effects. So yeah, I'm considering of just taking that out and just siding it in. And now for the hand traps, I play double Ghost Ogre and double Ash Blossom. Pretty self-explanatory. So that's all for the monster lineup. Total monsters is 22, I believe, or 24. So let's get right into the spells. Triple Fusion Destiny, you need to play 3 of them, otherwise the deck won't be as consistent that you want it to be. It starts out your plays to get your Maui in the graveyard a lot faster than Foolish Burial. Triple E-Call, pretty self-explanatory, just adds a hero. Level 4, adds an elemental hero. Triple Mass Change to get out your mass heroes. And I'm and I decided to start maining this now instead of siding it. Triple super polymerization. This card, if you were to go against like Sky Strikers and they play Shizuku, you can just activate this, fuse one of your heroes and Shizuku on your opponent's side of the field to go into absolute zero, which I find amazing. And I also play Starving Venom in this build, just to in case I go against a dark attribute deck. For the one-offs, we played the one reinforcement of the army, the one poly, and the one hero lives. I kind of wish this card was back at free, but then it would just make heroes way too busted, I believe. So keeping it at one is probably the smartest decision that Konami made. And lastly, for two trap cards in the last of my deck, two infinite and permanents, I would play a third one, but I'm kind of tight on a budget as is. That's it for the main deck. Let's move on to the extra deck. I played the one extra hero Dread Decimator, the one extra hero Wonder Driver, and two Cross Crusaders. This is like the only Link monsters that you really need in this deck, because due to Ferris's ability, if you use his effect, you can only special summon hero monsters for the rest of that turn. So, like any other Link 4, like Borlord, Borosword, or Mech Knight Arvermax, you can't really go into as much. So, this is all you really need is like 4 Link monsters. And then all the rest are just fusion. So, we got Vision Hero Trinity for the OTK plays. The one Adoration, in case I'm not able to go into Trinity, I just go into him with the polarization. And the Masked Hero Dion. As he sometimes come up whenever I have Solid Soldier on the field and I have a Master Agent in hand, but I really don't see him as much when I need him. The one Master Hero Enki to help search out the quick play Mass Change to get it out from my deck. The one Master Hero Divine Wind. Now you guys are maybe asking, why am I running Divine Wind? I'll tell you why I'm running Divine Wind. It's because a certain someone in TeamEccenTrick likes to OTK the living shit out of me with Mermouse. So I figured, okay, since I got a Mass Change and a Stratos, might as well summon Divine Wind and prevent him from attacking multiple times, and it can only attack with one monster. Like, shoutouts to Eric Radell and his Mermails, but seriously, dude, you need to calm down and know some TKs. Two Mass Hero Darklaw, the MVP of this deck, to help out banish your opponent's cards this much, but against like a deck called Thunder Dragons, it doesn't really help as much because it just helps them out more by banishing their Thunder Dragons. For the two Destiny heroes in the Fusion lineup, I got Dystopia, your main startup play with Fusion Destiny. If you send Celestial to your graveyard with Maui with the Fusion Destiny, you can activate Dystopia's effect and burn your opponent for 1600 points in damage. Can come in handy when you're in time. Just to, if your opponent if the judge calls time and you're trying to burn them, you would go into this. The one Destiny Hero Dangerous, he comes out sometimes, just not all the time. Unless I run out of materials, if I run out of Destiny Heroes on my deck with Fusion Destiny, I just go into him. Now the last two fusions in my deck is the one Absolute Zero and the one Starving Venom Fusion Dragon. I've been considering picking up Masked Hero Acid and just taking out the Starving Venom or the Divine Wind for it. But for right now, this is going to be the lineup of the extra deck. So guys, that's it for my deck profile. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Please like and subscribe to TeamEccenTrick. And leave your comments down in the section below to give me some tips on how to improve this deck a lot better. Hope you guys enjoyed this and my little commentary of the deck. This is Connor from TeamEccenTrick, signing out.
Rate and subscribe, leave your comments and ideas in the comments section below, and don't hesitate to give us respectful suggestions on content you want to see. Eric on behalf of the team saying take care, and TeamEccenTrick out.